This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. British Empire, United Kingdom, Australia. Khalil Pasha Kazim Karabekir Ali Ihsan Pasha. Strength 350,000 to 410,000. 300,000 casualties and losses. 92,000 casualties. 325,000 casualties. VE Mesopotamian Campaign. FAO Landing Basra Kurna Sheba Amara. S. Shin CTE Siphon at Tubal. First Cut Sheikh Saad Wadi Hanna Dujaila. Second Cut Baghdad Samara Offensive. Jebel Hamlin Istabulat Ramadi Khan Baghdadi Sharkat. VE Theaters of World War I. European Balkans. Western Front. Eastern Front. Italian Front. Middle Eastern. Caucasus. Persia. Gallipoli. Mesopotamia. Sinai and Palestine. Arab Revolt. South Arabia. African. Southwest Africa. Togoland. Cameroon. East Africa. North Africa. Asian and Pacific. Theater. Naval Theaters. U-Boat. Atlantic Ocean. Mediterranean. The Mesopotamian Campaign was a campaign in the Middle Eastern theater of World War I fought between the Allies represented by the British Empire, mostly troops from Britain and the Indian Empire, and the Central Powers, mostly of the Ottoman Empire. Contents 1. Background 2. Operations 21-1914-22-1915-23-1916-24-1917-25-1918. 251. Armistice of Mudros, October 3. Aftermath. 4 casualties. 5 battles of the campaign. 6. See also. 7 notes. 8 references. 9 external links. Background. The Ottoman Empire had conquered the region in the early 16th century, but never fully gained complete control. Regional pockets of Ottoman control through local proxy rulers maintained the Ottomans' reach throughout Mesopotamia. Modern Iraq. With the turn of the 19th century came reforms. Work began on a Baghdad railway in 1888. By 1915 it had only 4 gaps, and travel time from Istanbul to Baghdad had fallen to 21 days. The Anglo-Persian Oil Company had obtained exclusive rights to petroleum deposits throughout the Persian Empire, except in the provinces of Azerbaijan, Gilan, Mazandaran, Asdrabad, and Khorasan. In 1914, before the war, the British government had contracted with the company for oil for the navy. The operational area of the Mesopotamian campaign was limited to the lands watered by the rivers Euphrates and Tigris. The main challenge was moving the supplies and troops through the swamps and deserts which surrounded the area of conflict. Shortly after the European War started, the British sent a military force to protect Abadan, the site of one of the world's earliest oil refineries. British operational planning included landing troops in the Shatt al-Arab. The reinforced 6th Pune Division from the British Indian Army was assigned, designated as Indian Expeditionary Force DIEFD. Another reason for British effort in Mesopotamia, especially in the minds of politicians like Austen Chamberlain, Secretary of State for India and former Viceroy Lord Curzon, was to maintain British prestige with Indian Muslim opinion, and at first it was run by the India Office and Indian Army with little input from the War Office. The Ottoman 4th Army was located in the region. The army was composed of 2 corps, the 12th Corps with 35th and 36th Divisions at Mosul and 13th Corps with the 37th and 38th Divisions at Baghdad. On 29 October 1914, after the pursuit of Goban and Breslau, Breslau bombarded the Black Sea port of Theodosia. On 30 October the High Command in Istanbul changed the force distribution. On 2 November Grand Vizier Said Halim Pasha expressed regret to the Allies for the operations of the Navy. Russian Minister of Foreign Affairs Sergei Sazonov said it was too late in Russia. Considered this raid as an act of war. The cabinet tried to explain that hostilities were begun without its sanction by German officers serving in the Navy. The Allies insisted on reparations to Russia. The dismissal of German officers from the Goban and Breslau, and the internment of the German ships until the end of the war. But before the Ottoman government responded, Great Britain and France declared war on the Ottoman Empire. On 5 November the Ottoman Committee of Union and Progress's official declaration of war came on 14 November when the Caucasus campaign became a reality with the Bergman Offensive. Enver Pasha sent the 37th Division and the 13th Corps headquarters to the Caucasus in support of the 3rd Army. The entire 12th Corps was deployed to the Sinai and Palestine campaign. The 4th Army headquarters was sent to Syria, to replace the 2nd Army headquarters which went to Istanbul. In place of the 4th Army was Iraq Area Command, with only the 38th Division under its command. Mesopotamia was a low priority area for the Ottomans, and they did not expect any major action action in this region, regiments of the 12th and 13th Corps were maintained at low levels in peacetime. Lieutenant Colonel Suleiman Askari Bey became the commander. He redeployed portions of the 38th Division at the mouth of Shat al-Arab. The rest of the defensive force was stationed in Basra. The Ottoman General Staff did not even possess a proper map of Mesopotamia. They tried to draw a map with the help of some people who used to work in Iraq before the war. Although this attempt failed, Enver Pasha bought two German maps scaled 1/1,500,000. Operations 1914-1914, initial British offence on 6 November 1914, the British offensive began with the naval force bombarding the old fort at FAO, which was located at the point where the Shat al-Arab meets the Persian Gulf at the FAO landing. The British Indian Expeditionary Force DIEFD, comprising the 6th Pune Division led by Lieutenant General Arthur Barrett with Sir Percy Cox as political officer, was opposed by 350 Ottoman troops and 4 guns by mid-November. The Pune Division was fully ashore and moved towards the city of Basra in contribution to the war effort. Sheikh Mubarak al-Sabah, the ruler of Kuwait, sent a force to Qasr, Safwan, Bubiyan, and Basra to expel Ottoman forces from the area in November 1914. In exchange, the British government recognized Kuwait as an independent government under British protection. There is no report on the exact size and nature of Mubarak's attack, though Ottoman forces did retreat from those positions weeks later. Mubarak soon removed the Ottoman symbol that was on the Kuwaiti flag and replaced it with Kuwait written in Arabic script. Mubarak's participation and previous exploits in obstructing the completion of the Baghdad Railway helped the British safeguard the Persian Gulf by preventing Ottoman and German reinforcements. On 22 November, the British occupied the city of Basra against a force of Ottoman soldiers of the Iraq Area Command commanded by Sufi Bey, the governor of Basra. The Ottoman troops ran after a short fight, abandoning Basra and retreated farther up the river. The British occupied Basra and established order in the town. The British then continued their advance, and at the Battle of Kurna they succeeded in capturing Subi Bey and 1,000 of his Ottoman troops. That gave the British a very strong position and ensured that Basra and the oilfields would be protected from an Ottoman advance. The main Ottoman army, under the overall command of Khalil Pasha, was located 275 miles northwest around Baghdad. They made only weak efforts to dislodge the British. 1915 operations of 1915 July, British offence September, British offence November, British offence November, British offence detail December, siege of Kut on 2 January, Suleiman Askari Bey assumed the Iraq area command. The Ottoman army did not have any other resources at the time to move to this region because other areas such as Gallipoli, the Caucasus, and Palestine had higher priority. Suleiman Askari Bey sent letters to Arab sheikhs in an attempt to organize them to fight against the British. He wanted to retake the Shat al-Arab region at any cost. On 12 April, Suleiman Askari attacked the British camp at Sheba in what became known as the Battle of Sheba. He had about 4,000 regular troops and about 14,000 Arab irregulars. The attack started early in the morning. These forces provided by Arab sheikhs did not produce results. However, the Ottoman infantry launched a series of relentless attacks on the fortified British camp and later attempted by bypass it. When the British cavalry and infantry counterattacked, Suleiman Askari pulled his troops back. The next day the British attacked his defensive positions. It was a hard-fought infantry battle in which the British infantry overcame tough Ottoman opposition. Ottoman losses numbered 2,400 men killed, wounded, or taken prisoner, as well as 2 artillery field pieces lost. The retreat ended 75 miles up the river at Hamasiya. Suleiman Askari was wounded at Sheba. Disappointed and depressed, he shot himself at the hospital in Baghdad. In his place, Colonel Nuruddin was appointed commander of the Iraq Area Command. On 20 April 1915, Nuruddin was one of the few officers to reach high command without the benefit of a staff college education. He did, however, have extensive combat experience. Due to the unexpected success, British command reconsidered their plan and General Sir John Nixon was sent in April 1915 to take command. He ordered Charles Vere Furze Townsend to advance to Kut or even to Baghdad if possible. Townsend and his small army advanced up the Tigris River. They defeated several Ottoman forces sent to halt him logistically. His advance was very difficult to sustain, but it was sustained in late September 1915. Amidst the recent defeat of Serbia and entry of Bulgaria into the war and concerns about German attempts to incite jihad in Persia and Afghanistan, Grey Foreign Secretary and other politicians encouraged a further 100-mile push to Baghdad. The SIGs. Murray thought this logistically unwise, but Kitchener advised the Dardanelles Committee 21 October that Baghdad be seized for the sake of prestige, then abandoned. Enver Pasha, worried about the possible fall of Baghdad, he realized the mistake of underestimating the importance of the Mesopotamian campaign. He ordered the 35th Division and Mehmet Fazıl Pasha to return to their old location, which was Mosul. The 38th Division was reconstituted. The 6th Army was created on 5 October 1915, and its commander was a 72-year-old German general, Kolmar von der Goltz. Von der Goltz was a famous military historian who had written several classic books on military operations. He had also spent many years working as a military advisor in the Ottoman Empire. However, he was in Thrace commanding the Ottoman First Army and would not reach the theater for some time. Colonel Nuruddin, the former commander of the Iraq Area Command, was still in charge on the ground. On 22 November, Townsend and Nuruddin fought a battle at Cte Siphon, a town 25 miles south of Baghdad. The conflict lasted 5 days. The battle was a stalemate as both the Ottomans and the British ended up retreating from the battlefield. Townsend concluded that a full-scale retreat was necessary. However, Nuruddin realized the British were retreating and cancelled his retreat. Then followed the British. Townsend withdrew his division in good order back to Kut al-Amara. He halted and fortified the position. Nuruddin pursued with his forces. He tried to encircle the British with his 18th Corps, composed of the 45th Division, 51st Division and 2nd Tribal Cavalry Brigade. The exhausted and depleted British force was urged back to the defences of Kut al-Amara. The retreat finalised on 3 December. Nuruddin encircled the British at Kut al-Amara, and sent other forces downriver to prevent the British from marching to the relief of the garrison. Ottoman 6th Army Field HQ on 7 December. The Siege of Kut began from the Ottoman perspective. Siege of Kut prevented 6th Army to perform other operations from the British perspective. Defending Kut as opposed to retreating back to Basra was a mistake, since Kut was isolated. It could be defended, but it could not be resupplied. Von der Goltz helped the Ottoman forces build defensive positions around Kut. The 6th Army was reorganized into two corps, the 13 and the 18. Nuruddin Pasha gave command to von der Goltz. With the reorganization, the 6th Army laid siege to the British. New fortified positions established down river fended off any attempt to rescue Townsend. Townsend suggested an attempt to break out, but this was initially rejected by Sir John Nixon. However, he relented. Nixon established a relief force under the command of General Aylmer. General Aylmer made three major attempts to break the siege, but each effort was unsuccessful. 1916, on 20 January, Enver Pasha replaced Nuruddin Pasha with Colonel Halil Kut Khalil Pasha. Nuruddin Pasha did not want to work with a German general. He sent a telegram to the war ministry. The Iraq army has already proven that it does not need the military knowledge of Goltz Pasha. After the first failure, General Nixon was replaced by General Lake. British forces received small quantities of supplies from the air. These drops were not enough to feed the garrison, though Halil Kut forced the British to choose between starving or surrendering, though in the meantime they would try to lift the siege. Between January to March 1916, both Townsend and Aylmer launched several attacks in an attempt to lift the siege in sequence. The attacks took place at the Battle of Sheikh Saad, the Battle of the Wadi, the Battle of Hanna, and the Battle of Dujailah Redoubt. These series of British attempts to break through the encirclement did not succeed, and their costs were heavy. Both sides suffered high casualties. In February, 13th Corps received 2nd Infantry Division as a reinforcement. Food and hopes were running out for Townsend in Kut al-Amara. Disease were spreading rapidly and could not be cured. On 19 April, Field Marshal von der Goltz died of cholera. On 24 April, an attempt by the paddle steamer Jolner to resupply the town by river failed. With that, there was no way the British could resupply Kut after repeated attempts to break through the Ottoman attacks on the city. Rather than wait for reinforcements, Townsend surrendered on 29 April 1916. The remaining force in Kut al-Amara of 13,164 soldiers became captives of the Ottomans. The British viewed the loss of Kut as a humiliating defeat. It had been many years since such a large body of British Army soldiers had surrendered to an enemy. Also, this loss followed only 4 months after the British defeat at the Battle of Gallipoli. Nearly all the British commanders involved in the failure to rescue Townsend were removed from command. The Ottomans proved they were good at holding defensive positions against superior forces. The British refused to let the defeat at Kut withstand further attempts to advance in Mesopotamia were ordered by the politicians on the War Committee 18 September, including Curzon and Chamberlain, who argued that there would be no net savings in troops if a passive policy in the Middle East encouraged Muslim unrest in India, Persia and Afghanistan, and despite the opposition of Robertson, a major problem for the British was the lack of logistical infrastructure when ships arrived. At Basra, they had to be unloaded by small boats which then unloaded their cargo, which was then stored in warehouses, which there were not enough of in Basra. Ships often sat for days waiting to be unloaded. Then supplies had to be sent north along the river in shallow draft river steamers because there were almost no roads north. Usually the amount of supplies being sent north was barely adequate to supply the forces in place. A plan to build a railway was rejected by the Indian government in 1915, but after Kut it was approved. After the defeat at Kut, the British made a major effort to improve the ability to move men and equipment into theatre, and keep them supplied. The port at Basra was greatly improved so that ships could be quickly unloaded. Good roads were built around Basra. Rest camps and supply dumps were created to receive men and material from the port. More and better river steamers were put into service moving supplies up river. New hospitals were also set up to better care for the sick and wounded. As a result, the British were able to bring more troops and equipment to the front lines and keep them properly supplied. Applied for a new offensive. The new commander, General Maude, despite receiving secret orders from Robertson not to attempt to take Baghdad, was given additional reinforcements and equipment for the next 6 months. He trained and organized his army at the same time. The Ottoman 6th Army was growing weaker. Khalil Pasha received very few replacements, and ended up disbanding the weak 38th Division and used its soldiers as replacements for his other divisions, the 46th, 51st, 35th. And 52nd. Robertson changed his mind when it seemed that the Russians might advance to Mosul, removing any Turkish threat to Mesopotamia, and authorized Maude to attack in December 1916. 1917. General Maude's army captures Kut. A British and Turkish soldier during the Mesopotamian campaign. March 1917, British troops entering Baghdad. Maude's offensive was launched on 13 December 1916. The British advanced up both sides of the Tigris River, forcing the Ottoman army out of a number of fortified positions along the way. General Maude's offensive was methodical, organized, and successful. Khalil Pasha was able to concentrate most of his forces against Maude near Kut. However, Maude switched his advance to the other bank of the Tigris, bypassing most of the Ottoman forces. The Ottoman 18th Corps escaped destruction only by fighting some desperate rear guard actions. It did lose quite a bit of equipment and supplies. The British occupied Kut and continued to advance up the Tigris by early March. The British were at the outskirts of Baghdad, and the Baghdad garrison, under the direct command of the governor of Baghdad province Halil Kut. Khalil Pasha tried to stop them on the Diyala River. General Maude outmaneuvered the Ottoman forces, destroyed an Ottoman regiment and captured the Ottoman defensive positions. Khalil Pasha retreated in disarray out of the city on the 11th of March 1917. The British entered Baghdad, where they were greeted as liberators. The British Indian Army played a significant role in the liberation of Baghdad amidst the confusion of the retreat. A large part of the Ottoman army, some 15,000 soldiers, were captured a week after the city fell. General Maude issued the oft-quoted proclamation of Baghdad, which contained the famous line, "Our armies do not come into your city and lands as conquerors or enemies, but as liberators." Khalil Pasha withdrew his battered 6th Army upriver and established his headquarters in Mosul. He had about 30,000 total troops with which to oppose Maude. In April, he received the 2nd Infantry Division, but overall the Ottoman strategic position was bad. In the spring of 1917, after the capture of Baghdad, Maude stopped his advance. He felt his supply lines were too long, conditions in the summer made campaigning difficult, and he had been denied reinforcements he felt he needed. General Maude died of cholera on 18 November. He was replaced by General William Marshall, who halted operations for the winter 1918, reaching Little Zab River, 120 kilometers in 2 days. The British resumed their offensive in late February 1918, capturing Hit and Khan al Baghdadi in March, and Kifri in April. For the rest of the 1918, the British had to move troops to the Sinai and Palestine campaign in support of the Battle of Megiddo. General Marshall moved some of the forces east in support of General Lionel Dunsterville's operations in Persia. During the summer of 1918, his very powerful army was astonishingly inactive, not only in the hot season but through most of the cold. The fight in Mesopotamia was not wanted anymore. Armistice conditions between the Allies and the Ottoman Empire began negotiations with the turn of October. General Marshall, following instructions from the War Office that every effort was to be made to score as heavily as possible on the Tigris before the whistle blew, went on the offensive for the last time. General Alexander Cobb commanded a British force from Baghdad on the 23rd of October 1918. Within 2 days it covered 120 kilometers, reaching the Little Zab River, where it expected to meet and engage the Ottoman 6th Army operating under Ismail Haki Bey. He fought a battle at the Battle of Sharkot, capturing nearly the entire Ottoman force. Armistice of Mudros, October. On the 30th of October 1918, the Armistice of Mudros was signed and both parties accepted their current positions. General Marshall accepted the surrender of Khalil Pasha and the Ottoman 6th Army at the same day, but Cobb did not hold his current position as the armistice required, and continued to advance on Mosul in the face of Turkish protests. British troops marched unopposed into Mosul on 14 November 1918. The ownership of the Mosul province and its rich oil fields became an international issue. The war in Mesopotamia was over on 14 November 1918. It was 15 days after the armistice and 1 day after the occupation of Istanbul. Commanders Mirliva Khalil Pasha, Mirilay Kazim Bey, Muzir Gultz Pasha, Major General Townsend, 6th Army Staff. Aftermath. See also: partitioning of the Ottoman Empire with British Indian forces already on the ground. The British imported civil servants from India who had previous knowledge and experience on how the government of a colony is supposed to run. The expulsion of Ottomans from the region shook the centuries-old power balance. Arabs who believed that the expulsion of the Ottomans would lead to greater independence and fought against the Ottoman forces along the Allies faced another dilemma. They were disappointed with the arguments regarding the establishment of British Mandate of Mesopotamia. Three important anticolonial secret societies had been formed in the region during 1918 and 1919 at Najaf. Jamayat and Nada al-Islamiyah. The League of the Islamic Awakening was organized. Al-Jamayah al-Wataniyah al-Islamiyah. The Muslim National League was formed with the object of organizing and mobilizing the population for major resistance in February 1919. In Baghdad, a coalition of Shia merchants, Sunni teachers and civil servants, Sunni and Shia ulama, and Iraqi officers formed the Haris al-Istiqlal, the Guardians of Independence. The Istiqlal had member groups in Karbala, Najaf, Kut, and Hilla. The British were in a precarious situation with the issue of Mosul. They were adopting almost desperate measures to protect their interests. The Iraqi revolt against the British developed just after they declared their authority. It was put down by the RAF Iraq Command during the summer of 1920. The Ottoman Parliament mostly accepted the cession of the region, but they had a different view on the issue of Mosul. They declared the Misak-i-Mili. Misak-i-Mili stated that the Mosul province was a part of their heartland, based on a common past, history, concept of morals and laws. Presumably, from a British perspective, if Mustafa Kemal Ataturk succeeded in securing the stability in his efforts to establish Republic of Turkey, he would have turned his attention to recovering Mosul and penetrate into Mesopotamia, where the native population would probably join him. The British Foreign Secretary attempted to disclaim any existence of oil in the Mosul area on 23 January 1923. Lord Curzon argued that the existence of oil was no more than hypothetical. However, according to Armstrong, England wanted oil. Mosul and Kurds were the key casualties. Madras Regiment War Memorial, Bangalore, mentions lives lost in Mesopotamia by the Madras sappers. The British and the British Indian Army forces suffered 92,000 casualties in the Mesopotamian campaign, including 27,000 killed, half by disease. Ottoman losses were much higher, totaling 325,000 by the end of 1918. The British had deployed 350,000 to 410,000 men into the area. 112,000 of them were combat troops. The vast majority of the British Empire forces in this campaign were recruited from India. Battles of the campaign: FAO Landing, Fall of Basra, Battle of Kurna, Battle of Sheba, Battle of Eschin, Battle of Cte Siphon, Siege of Kut, Attempts to relieve Kut, Battle of Sheikh Saad, Battle of the Wadi, Battle of Hanna, Battle of Dujaila Redoubt, First Battle of Kut, Second Battle of Kut, Fall of Baghdad, Samarra Offensive, Battle of Jebel Hamlin, Battle of Istiblat, Battle of Ramadi, Action of Khan Baghdadi, Battle of Sharkot. See also: World War I Portal, Ottoman Empire, Dissolution of the Ottoman Empire, Tanzimat, Second Constitutional Era of the Ottoman Empire, Young Turks Notes, Carat A B Slot 2005, pp. Carat slot 2005, p. 1914-1918 Dial Press, New York, 1967, 148-149 A.J. Barker, The Bastard War, The Mesopotamia Campaign of 1914-1918 Dial Press, New York, 1967, 271 A.J. Barker, The Bastard War, The Mesopotamia Campaign of 1914-1918 Dial Press, New York, 1967, 272 Edward J. Erickson, Ordered to Die, A History of the Ottoman Army in the First World War, Greenwood Press, Westport, CT 2001, 164 Woodward, 1998, pp. 122-167 Edward J. Erickson, Ordered to Die, A History of the Ottoman Army in the First World War, Greenwood Press, Westport, CT 2001, 165 A.B. Edward J. Erickson, Ordered to Die, A History of the Ottoman Army in the First World War, Greenwood Press, Westport, CT 2001, 166 Cyril Falls, The Great War, pg 329 ABC Peter Sluglett, The Primacy of Oil in Britain's Iraq Policy, in the book Britain in Iraq, 1914-1932, London, Ithaca Press, 1976, pp 103-116 Harold Courtenay Armstrong Grey Wolf, Mustafa Kemal, An Intimate Study of a Dictator, page 225 References F. J. Moberly, The Campaign in Mesopotamia, 4 vols, 1923-27, HMSO, Official History A. J. Barker 1967 The Neglected War Faber and Faber A. J. Barker 2009 The First Iraq War, 1914-1918, Britain's Mesopotamian Campaign New York, Enigma Books ISBN 978-1-929631-865 Published in 1967 in Britain as the Neglected War Mesopotamia Campaign, from the Long, Long Trail website, downloaded November, 2014 Mesopotamia Campaign, from the Commonwealth War Graves Commission newsletter, downloaded June, 2011 Slot, B.J. 2005 Mubarak al-Sabah, founder of modern Kuwait 1896-1915 London, Arabian Publishing ISBN. Britain Cooper Bush 1971 Britain, India, and the Arabs 1914-1921 University of California Press Wilcox, Ron 2006 Battles on the Tigris Pen and Sword Military Woodward, David R. Field Marshal Sir William Robertson, Westport, Connecticut. Akkadian Empire Babylonia Assyria Neo-Assyrian Empire Neo-Babylonian Empire Achaemenid Assyria Seleucid Babylonia Parthian Babylonia Sassanid Assyristan 638-1958 Muslim Conquest of Persia Abbasid Caliphate Bayad Dynasty Kara Koyunlu Ak Koyunlu Safavids Ottoman Iraq Kingdom of Iraq Arab Federation Republic 1958-68-1968-2003-2003-11-2011 Present Arab Socialist Ba'ath Party, Iraq Region. Civil War 2014 Present Geography Al-Fau Peninsula Al-Jazeera Euphrates Hamran Mountains Persian Gulf Islands Mesopotamia Mesopotamian Marshes Places Lakes Shat al-Arab Syrian Desert Tigris Khazar Zagros Mountains Politics Administrative Divisions Constitution Council of Representatives Legislative Elections Foreign Aid Foreign Relations Government Council of Ministers Presidency Council President Prime Minister Human Rights in pre-Saddam Iraq in Saddam Hussein's Iraq in post-invasion Iraq in ISIL-controlled territory law military Police Political Parties Judiciary Wars and Conflicts Economy Central Bank Dinar Currency Infrastructure Oil Industry Oil Reserves Reconstruction Stock Exchange Telecommunications Transportation Society Cuisine Culture Education Health Media Music Sports Demographics Iraqis Diaspora Languages Arabic Aramaic Kurdish Persian Turkmen Minorities Armenians Assyrians Circassians Kurds Mandaeans Persians Saluba Turkmen Religion Islam Christianity Mandaeism Yazidis. Outline Index Category Portal VE World War I Home Fronts. Theaters European Balkans Western Front Eastern Front Italian Front Middle Eastern Gallipoli Sinai and Palestine Caucasus Persia Mesopotamia South Arabia African Southwest East Cameroon Togoland. North Asian and Pacific Tsingtao German New Guinea and Samoa at Sea North Atlantic U-Boat Campaign Mediterranean North Sea Baltic Indian, Pacific. Participants People Entente Powers China French Empire Belgium British Empire Greece Italy Japan Montenegro Portugal Romania Russia Russian Empire Russian Republic Serbia United States Central Powers Germany Austria Hungary Ottoman Empire Bulgaria Timeline Pre-war conflicts Scramble for Africa 1880-1914 Russo-Japanese War 1905 First Moroccan Tangier Crisis 1905-06 Agadir Crisis 1911 Italo-Turkish War 1911-12 French Conquest of Morocco 1911-12 First Balkan War 1912-13 Second Balkan War 1913 Prelude Origins Sarajevo Assassination